Good day, class. You are welcome to Primary 5 Vocational Aptitude class. I'm Anne Folarin from Pace Private School. In our last class, we looked at types of metal and we established that we have ferrous and non-ferrous metal. We learned that ferrous metals are metals that contain iron, while non-ferrous metals are metals that don't contain iron. We also look at an alloy. We say it's a mixture of metals. And with that on mind, we'll be looking at our today's class, which is on electricity transmission equipment. Electricity transmission equipment. Now, what is electricity? Electricity transmission is the process of bringing electricity from the point of generation to the point of consumption. For instance, PSCN, they generate electricity and they send it to the consumer, that is the point of consumption, where we use such electricity on our television set, our radio set, our fan to operate them, etc. Now, there are basic electricity transmission equipment like the generator. Generators are devices that convert mechanical energy to electrical energy. And generators are built to supply a specific amount of current according to its capacity. Then we have another equipment as the switch or switches. Switches are used for making and breaking electrical circuits. The switch are used to switch on and also to switch off current. That's in a literal term. You switch on and switch off current. What about transformer? We have two types of transformer. We have what we call the step-up transformer. When we say step-up, it means those transformers that increase the voltage of the electricity when it is low. We also have the step-down transformers. These are the types that reduces the voltage of electricity supply when it is too high. So, transformer is more of a regulator. And we have primary and secondary section in that transformer, known as the inputs, where you connect in, and the output, where you get your results. We also have another equipment as the cable. Now, the wires which carry electric current are long transmission lines are called cables. And there are different sizes of cable. We also have the socket outlets. If you look around your house, you'll see different types of socket outlets. And what are they used for? They are used to send electric currents to appliances. And they are of different qualities. There are some that cannot be used for high voltage because of consuming appliances like air conditioner. It's not every socket outlet you use for it because of its high voltage. Then we have what we call the lamp holders. As the name suggests, they are used to hold lamp. What lamp are we referring to here? We're talking about bulbs. They hold bulb in place and they are also of different sizes. We have the circuit breaker. It is specifically designed to switch automatically. It is designed to switch automatically. It will open electric circuit when there is excessive flow due to a fault. So this circuit breaker helps to control when there is a fault. I will want you to feel free to make use of the class forum If you have any question, drop it on the forum. And then I want you to work on, you again, work on page 98 to 102. The main exercise is on page 101 and 2. But I would like you to read more on the electric city transmission. And then your quiz for the week will come up as the week goes by. Stay safe, maintain social distancing, and let your light shine. Thank you.